In the metals quadrant today, taking a look at an industrial metal, copper, which finished the day up 1.05% approximately, a little bit up over 1%. On the high side, that December contract was up 1.4% at 3.189. On the downside, 3.1275, which was down 55 basis points. So that two-day rally allowed copper to turn positive for the week and have a second consecutive week higher. Even though today seemed like a little bit of short covering, there was not a ton of volume involved in the copper market today, but we did end higher and we do have our second consecutive week higher. A little bit of supply news over the last, say, 24 hours, which you would have thought would have given a little bit of a headwind, possibly part of the reason we had low volume on the upside move today. The Candelaria copper mine, which is on strike right now, the owners have put a sweetened deal before the union. We don't know if the union's going to accept it at this point, but we do know that that deal is on the table. So a little bit of optimism there. They are one of the largest copper mines in the world in Chile. And Colombian coal mine Cedillon on Friday requested the labor ministry convene an arbitration tribunal to solve the dispute with their largest mine, their largest workers union. And that strike's going on for 70 days. Again, not a ton of production out of that mine relative to something like Candelaria out of Chile, but it still is a supply factor, a little bit more copper on the market for China to take a look at if they were actually to settle that strike. Not a lot of Chinese data coming in the next few days. Now, in terms of the opposite, the inverse correlation, which of course is the dollar trend lower is still intact after a day lower today for the dollar index. On a weekly basis, the dollar did not close above that 92.90 level, which would be critical for it to even move into neutral. So on a medium-term basis, again, looking at the weekly charts, which you can only look at on a Friday close, we did not get a close high enough to take that downtrend away. So the downtrend for the dollar still intact. That's a little bit of a tailwind for all commodities, but especially affects copper, all else equal.